Hi, so what I want to talk about in this video today is one of the first things I'd recommend doing when you visit Cape Town, and that's taking a trip up Table Mountain, or as it's known in Afrikaans, Tafelberg. Now, 5 visits later and the sight of Table Mountain still takes my breath away, especially as you fly into Cape Town and you see that very first sight of the mountain. It really is beautiful. And Table Mountain looks especially majestic when it has what they call its tablecloth on top. Now, Table Mountain is called Table Mountain because the top of the mountain is absolutely flat like a tabletop, and the cloud just sits on top of that mountain, and it looks especially beautiful when the wind just blows and you see the cloud just spilling over. It really is beautiful. Now, out of the 4 times I've been up the mountain, 3 of the times we've been up in the morning, and we've always queued for about 1 to 2 hours. One year we went up in the afternoon, and I don't know if it was just a fluke for that particular afternoon, but we had no queuing at all. We walked up to the ticket office, bought our tickets, and then went up in the cable car straight away. And that was between about 3 and 4 in the afternoon. So if you're taking a trip up Table Mountain, I would recommend trying in the afternoon first. Now, there's 2 ways up the mountain. One is to hike up. I've never hiked up the mountain. A quick search online, they say it takes between 1 to 2 hours from the cable car house to the top of the mountain, depending on your fitness. Apparently there's lots of different walks up there and they do vary in difficulty, and I will put a link to 1 or 2 of the websites that I've looked at that talk about that. Like I say, it's not something I've done, but I would definitely recommend if you're going to do that, then you need to be properly kitted out. So closed-toed shoes which tie up at the ankle. I would say no matter what the weather, you must take water with you. And it's advisable in the hot weather to wear sun lotion and a hat. So if you're going to hike up the mountain, you do need to be properly kitted out. It's not like walking up a hill. If you're like me and you're going to get the cable car up, then the cable car's nice because as it goes up, it rotates and you get a 360 degree views of the area, and it really is stunning. So once you're on top of the mountain, you've got various walks, and the walks are all very well signposted. And again, even if you're going up in cable car, I would recommend you wear sensible shoes because some of the paths on the walks are a little bit uneven. We did have somebody in our party wearing flip-flops who actually sprained their ankle, so I would recommend sensible shoes. There's lots of flora and fauna on top of the mountain, so if you're interested in that, you can spot that on the walks. There's lizards and also what they call darcies, which is the closest living relative to an elephant. It's nowhere near the size of an elephant. It's kind of the size of an oversized guinea pig, but they're very, very cute. And it's nice just to, if you don't want to walk, it's nice just to sit there and take in the views. And if you look to your right, you've got the city and you can see Robben Island. And if you look to your left, you've got Camps Bay. There is also apparently guided walks, although I've not seen them. Something else you can do on top of the mountain if you're feeling particularly adventurous is you can abseil off. I think this might be next on my list. And there's a company which I saw that was recommended called Abseil Africa, and I will link them below as well. So that's Abseil Africa, and that is separate from the Table Mountain tickets. There's also a gift shop and a restaurant on top of the mountain. And something else I'm going to talk about in this video is the city sightseeing bus. And the reason I talk about that is we've done the Red Route, which is the city sightseeing tour, and it also goes up to Table Mountain, although I think you have to buy your tickets for the Table Mountain entry separately, so do check that out. And then another nice thing to do once you've done the city sightseeing tour, you've gone up the mountain, would be to come down, and there's a stop at Camps Bay, so you can get off there and you can have lunch and walk along the beach. So I think that's something that would be very nice to do in your first few days there. Now, the sightseeing bus has got lots of different routes and they're all colour-coded, so we've only done the red one. Now, another one to do is the purple wine tour. Now, this incorporates 3 wine estates, and actually that would be a really nice thing to do instead of having to drive there and worry about who's gonna drive and who's not gonna be able to drink. So you can get the purple tour, and that incorporates 3 wine estates. The blue tour seems to be the longest and seems to encompass the most from the other tours, and I think they said that one's the one that's the most value for money. So I'll link the website for the city sightseeing bus below. Have a look, it is very informative. The other one is the Blue Mini Peninsula Tour, and that goes to Hout Bay. It also incorporates apparently Kirstenbosch and one of the townships as well. You've got the Cape Point Explorer, which does day excursions to Cape Point Nature Reserve. Now, I have been to Cape Point Nature Reserve. It is a very nice drive. It is a nice thing to do. Not so much our cup of tea, but you know, I do think it's something that's worth seeing if you're going to Cape Town. There's the Yellow Downtown Tour. I've not done this, but this sounds lovely. It's a cultural and historical tour, so I think I might do this next time. And that incorporates the South Africa Museum, the District 6 Museum, which I really want to go to, I haven't been to yet, and also the Castle of Good Hope, which is another thing I haven't been to, so actually I do want to do this Yellow Downtown Tour next time we go. There's some pictures at the end of this video of our trips to Table Mountain, and there is also a video on there of the clouds spilling over the edge, which I spoke about briefly earlier, for you to see. As always, I'm always keen to hear from you, so if anybody has been to Table Mountain, or if anybody is from South Africa, then please do come and share your comments with me. If there's anything I've said that's incorrect, please do let me know. And it would be really great to hear from you. You can either contact me in the comments below, or if you want to get in touch with me via email, my email address is kelly.learnlanguage@gmail.com. So it's kelly.learnlanguage@gmail.com. Also, I'd like to say thank you to Sandra. Sandra got in touch after the restaurant video, and she wanted to recommend a restaurant in Plattekloof. And the restaurant's called Café Chameleon. I've been on their website and it does look really nice. It's Plattekloof, Café Chameleon. Apparently they do really lovely cakes, so I'm definitely going there next time. And that's in the northern suburbs, so thank you, Sandra, for that. That's really great. I think that's just about everything for now. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and do stay tuned for the photos and the video after. And if you want to get in contact with me, I'll look forward to hearing from you. Thank you for now. Bye.